ballot initiatives were made for marijuana, and there were big decisions overnight on that front. John Avlon here with a reality check on all the ballot issues.
That's the only one you care about, isn't it?
I feel like it's the only one you hear about. Every 2 years, marijuana is on the ballot again.
And the wisdom of the people overrides their state legislatures again and again.
I'm not taking a position. I'm just saying it's there.
Well, it's an interesting result we had this year. So, yeah, marijuana legalization, but also felon voting rights, redistricting reform. Those are just some of the ballot initiatives that passed last night in election 2018. And if you look at the whole spectrum of 158 statewide ballots, you get the sense that America's far more interesting and evolving than the old red state, blue state stereotype would suggest. So let's start here. The swing state of Michigan just legalized recreational marijuana, while conservative Utah and Missouri voted to allow medical marijuana. But while those states are singing Peter Tosh's Legalize It, Allie, that was for you, voters in North Dakota echoed Merle Haggard in Okie from Muskogee. They don't smoke marijuana in Dakota. They just turned down a legalization measure by almost 20 points. Now, if you're concerned about the polarization of American politics, voters in Michigan, Colorado, and Missouri approved nonpartisan independent redistricting commissions, which will effectively end the rigged system of redistricting and lead to more competitive general elections for Congress and more representative results. Now, the fight for voting rights was a big theme this year, and voters in Florida decided to restore voting rights to felons who've served their time going forward. Nevada backed automatic voter registration. Maryland approved same-day voter registration. Now, on the flip side, in the South, Arkansas and North Carolina backed requirements to show voter ID at the polls. Now, we all know polls said health care was issue number one for voters this year, and citizens of Idaho, Nebraska, and Utah are now requiring their conservative states to accept Obamacare's Medicaid expansion. It's a big deal. Massachusetts voters refused to roll back transgender rights after passage of a 2016 bill that was backed by the state's now re-elected Republican Governor Charlie Baker. And Alabama backed a symbolic proposal to allow the Ten Commandments to be posted in public spaces, which will almost certainly face legal challenges, while also asserting the rights of anti-abortion principles and, quote, the rights of unborn children in the state constitution. Now, and crimes victims' rights proposal, known as Marcy's Law, controversial because it adds costs and complexity to legal proceedings, passed in six states throughout the South and West. So that's your reality check.